Good day, YouTubers, subscribers, and everybody serious about heavenly stuff. Now, we are uncovering all these lies and myths and things that they've been teaching us all these years. So, today's video is revealing the truth about the earth, flat earth versus the round earth that they've been teaching us. Now, the Bible is so clear that the earth is not round, it's flat. Okay, it describes it very clear. I don't know how these scientists managed to teach us that the earth is round and we believe them. But anyway, I'm going to show you different verses in the Bible that actually prove that the earth was never, ever round. It was always flat. And the way it was created to be flat, and there was water up there, and there's no precipitation. When it rains, it's not a result of precipitation or anything like that. It's a result of Sonini, the Father Creator, opening the gates up in heaven up there and letting the water that is up there to come down to earth as he wishes. And then sometimes decides that it gotta be snow, it gotta be fog, gotta be dew every morning. So he decides whatever he wants to rain down. So it's not a result of some precipitation or some heat, heating some, you know, it's not a result of that. But anyway, so let's get into the Bible verses that actually prove that the earth was round and there's waters up there that keep raining down when it rains, okay? Now, Genesis 1:6 says, and the Father, now I don't like using them Greek names, God, Lord, and those, but what I'm reading is going to be showing them Greek names, so I won't say it. And the Creator said, let there be at a firmament in the midst of the waters, okay? Now, remember, like the chapters before this one, there was big ball of water on earth, okay? Big ball of water, and then suddenly the Creator decided to divide this water, okay, into two. Okay, so now that's the part that I'm reading here. Because that's after he had the light and day. I mean, I'm not touching that part. That's before. So this part I'm reading is, he says, they let it be firm. A firmament is something that makes something firm. Okay, like, okay, I'm going to show you pictures. And let it divide the waters from waters. Okay, so that means this big ball of water must have space in between so that there must be water up and the water down. Okay, and then there's be empty space with oxygen that we're breathing right now in between. Okay, and now read verse 7. And the Father, the Creator, said, made the firmament and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters above the firmament. Okay, now you understand. So let's look at a little picture there. Little picture says the water above the firmament and the water below the firmament. Do you understand now? So the firmament is the sky. Another part of the Bible says the firmament is the sky. But that's the part that allows us to stay without getting all the waters falling on top of our heads. That's a firmament. It firms up. Okay? The waters above. So they don't fall down as not as undesired, like the flood or anything like that. Okay? So it stays up there. You saw it in yourself up there. So let's read up to 8 now. Genesis 1:8. And the Father said, and Sonini said, okay, let me say his name so everybody realize that that's his name. And suddenly called the firmament heaven, okay? And the evening and the morning, okay. So that's the firmament. Some people say, no, the firmament is called the sky, but it don't matter. That there is a firmament up there, okay? So that's the firmament, and something make it firm. The water is not to fall down on top of our head. Do you understand now? I'm just talking about now the firmament, and then there's waters above and the waters below. Now, these people, when they're talking about the earth is round, now they have to start supporting the argument of the earth is round, because the Bible doesn't support that. The Bible talks about there's a firmament up and down. Now, when the earth is round, there ain't no firmament in there. It's just earth round, and then there's the bottom part of it. So the scientists are only accounting for the bottom part of the water. They're not accounting for the top part of the water that's held up by the firmament, as we just read now in the Bible. See, miss a firmament, divide waters from above and waters below. That's so clear already, counts out that round earth thing, where there is no firmament, it's just round earth. You see, this week, I don't know why they're feeding us all this, you know, the earth is round. Just look at that picture that I'm showing you. You can read on your own Genesis 1 and you see how earth was created. There's nothing talking about it was round, and it talks about earth was there was the top part of the water, and then it starts talking about the let's look at the other part. I mean, the bottom part. Now we spoke about the top part of the earth, where the top part was the water affirmed by something, so that it don't fall down. And then now Genesis 1:9 says, and suddenly said, let the waters under the heaven be the, now under that firmament up in the sky. Okay, be gathered together in one place, and let the dry land appear. Now that's where we live in it, walking around. So that's the water under. Now you remember it was divided to top and the bottom waters. So the top waters is what regularly gives periodically give us the rain and fog and snow and everything else that falls. But then because now the ice, I'll show you how we get that water to turn to ice, to turn to whatever form. I'll show you just now. The Bible is also clear how that water changes form and rains down in a different form. I'll show you. And then suddenly, now that's 10. And then suddenly called the dry land earth. And the gathering together of the water is called them seas. That's what we're walking on every day. So that I'm talking about the bottom end of the waters, because he further divided it into dry and then the water stays water, and he called the seas. Probably put salt on it. So do you understand now? This is so clear. But I mean, a lot of us don't read that much, so we just listen to whatever they're teaching us. And these people are taking advantage of the fact that we don't read on our own, then they start feeding us poison. I mean, the Bible doesn't even talk about, these scientists are really, really, I don't know. I mean, that just shows how they're not as smart as people think they are, because if the Bible is so clear and they come up with something like this around earth, I mean, that's really crazy, so crazy. I mean, somebody smart would at least try something that's closely related to what describes in the Bible, and then, you know, come up with something intelligent that is going to be believable. But now these people, the only success factor they're banking on is the fact that we don't read. That's it. Not them being smart and changing everything to look believable. No, it's the fact that we don't read. Because it's simple. You just open the Bible, Genesis 1, and uncover, and all of their years and hundreds of years of work is thrown out the window. Because there's nothing else supporting what's written in the Bible. You can see, for example. And then what's up with this? They're talking about the earth is spinning at about 1,000 miles per hour. That's like 1,600 kilometers an hour. I mean, that's too fast. They say, no, the earth is spinning, right? You know, spinning. Just imagine, you know, that jet, you know, when you fly, you know, international. So that jet flies at a speed of 500 miles per hour. That's 800 kilometers per hour if you convert it. 500 miles per hour, that's fast. I'm talking about just a jet now. Now, if that fast jet, you know how fast it is. If that fast jet is half the speed of the earth, how fast are we spinning here? We're talking about like even a tumble dryer ain't that fast. We're really spinning, according to the scientists. How do we even spin? I mean, if you look at how the world earth was created, we're surrounded by waters on top, and then we start spinning. How do we spin in that space where there's waters on top and the bottom, and then everything will be mixed up? You understand now? So these scientists are really, I don't really get where they're, you know, getting this thing off and everything is spinning, or we gotta be spinning. I mean, look at this video here. They're talking about there's other planets. The earth got other planets, and I mean, the Bible don't even talk about suddenly creating any other planet, but only the one that we live in, the earth. And then he created this dome, this habitat. It's like we're in a habitat, living in this dome. And then I'll show you why. I'm just showing the lie they're showing, and I'll show you why they're telling us these lies. Why are they, you know, working so hard to hide the fact that the earth is not round? The earth is a dome. And if you're outside the dome, you're out. You're not in the scheme. Now, they're talking about the earth is one of them other planets. At first, they were talking about there was 9, there was 7, there was 9, and then there's a Nibiru latest edition and Planet X. They keep adding. They're not even sure what they're talking about. So they say all these were orbiting around the sun. So we've got this axis, we're orbiting. So the moon is part of the situation. So apparently the sun is not moving. According to the scientists, sun is not moving. Look at them picture there. And then all the planets are moving around the sun. Earth is just one of the planets. And the Bible does not support none of this. Because first of all, the earth and the moon are the two entities that are mentioned in there that were created. I mean, besides the stars in it, the earth and the moon is there. The sun rise from the east to west, just goes there, round east to west, that's it, that's all it does, it rises from east to west. Now, how it resets back to the east to rise again, Sonini knows, he probably tells it, now, go back to east, and then go rise again, every morning, settle in the west, and then start again, go back, I don't know how it goes, but Sonini knows. But there's no spinning. We are not spinning. The earth is not spinning to facilitate that movement. So the earth, now according to them pagans, the earth is spinning and then the sun is spinning as well. The moon is spinning as well. Now how chaotic is it? I mean, I can't even think about how they imagine to convince us that this is the truth. Everything is spinning. And that earth, now even in their pictures, they can't even show the earth spinning at that 1,600 kilometers per hour. Because it won't make sense. They won't be in sync with everything else that's going on. And the Bible is not supporting that. I mean, think about it. So now, here is something. Here is the, I think, is the main reason why these people are lying about, talking about, you know, there is, the earth is spinning and there's other planets and stuff. Remember the Bible talking about there's under the earth. There's a place under, because they don't want us to know that there's a place called under the earth, because that's where they were sentenced to be, and it's complete darkness. You cannot see any light unless you're on the surface of the earth. If you're not on the surface of, you're not in the dome, because now that's the habitat. That's our habitat. If you're not in the habitat, you're under the earth. You're outside. There's no other place. You can't enter through the waters. Those waters have a firmament, and you can't go through. The only entrance is under there. I don't know if you see that picture. The only, that shield, you go under that shield and you are gone. That's it for you. So, and that shield, you go into the outer darkness, as Matthew even talks about. But the sons of the kingdom will be cast out, outer darkness. It's outer darkness, and there's under the earth. Look at the under earth. And no man in heaven nor under the earth. Now, if the earth was round, how do we get the under the earth then? Because everything else is just around the earth. Now, if you even remember that picture of all the planets, how is it under the earth? If there's other planets going on, then all of a sudden everybody is under the earth. According to the, and Philippians is taking a step on this thing under the earth. That at the name of the Savior, every knee bow of things in heaven and things on earth and things under the earth. Just think about it. So there's things in heaven up in that firmament we still spoke about. And things on earth, that's the bottom part of that firmament. Remember? In Genesis 1. And then things under the earth, that's the third part. So there's the third part, which is under the earth, which is the dark, stinky, sulfur, stinky, worms, undying. It's the filthiest ever place any person would want to be in. But they don't want the pride. Shh. The pride doesn't allow them to even acknowledge the existence of that place, because that's where they were sentenced to stay at. But then they keep popping up back to earth through that shield. They keep popping up back to earth, if you see that picture there. Popping up back to earth because of the sins that we're making on earth, inviting them, all them blood sacrifices, and then that gives them authority to come up and live and walk around on top of the earth. But of course, they have to wear the same bodies that are functioning on earth. Which is, you know, so the reptilians and all the nasty people, nasty things that are under the earth. They have to come up on earth and wear a body that won't scare us on earth, on top of the earth. So there's their outer darkness, that's where they at. But the pride don't allow them to acknowledge this place. That's why they're lying, talking about the earth is round. And then they live in the center of the earth, and it's a cute little place where they live. They got every resources, highways, and they were talking about the sophisticated technologies in the center. They ain't no such. The one thing they have is, fine, when Sonini created them, there were angels, fallen angels, you know. I suspect even the watchers, they are helping this. the watchers are helping this because the watchers were given all these skills, you know, to make stuff so they can serve us on earth. But now they started being smart and start thinking, no, they can actually do this for themselves. And probably the devil, who was fired already, way with his third demons, started approaching these watchers and say, hey, watchers, do y'all want to be watching them black folks here? Y'all can take over this earth. Only if you can do this and this and this and this. And then the watchers with all them skills started turning around and making airplanes, making all these technologies for themselves instead of serving us. So that's exactly what I think that's happening. Just that it's not written in the Bible anywhere. But I think that's because everything just makes sense that way. Because we know in the book of, you know, there were watchers that came after the devil and these demons were fired from heaven. So that, and those watchers already, they were Semjat and them, they started messing up and they were fired as well. And now if they were sent to be watchers for us, that means they were given certain kind of skills. And those are the skills and capabilities they started using against us. Started and trying to empower the kingdom of darkness, kingdom of the devil. Which is, now all these technologies, they probably, in that outer darkness, they probably started building all them technologies and spaceship and all them things in there to make it habitable for them. But it's still outer darkness. That's the way it is. There's no fun and sun and they're still stinking. Because even when them spaceships come up here, they'll be stinking, really stinking sulfur. You know how sulfur, like a rotten egg? That stink. That's really thing. I mean, speak to the people who've been abducted by aliens and they'll be going on the hypnosis things. You'll see that they say the same thing. That stink. I mean, it's just all really sad. It's sad. It's bad down there. It's really bad. It's not as fun as it. So there's outer darkness and there's under the earth and you can just see. So that's why they don't want people to realize that, because that's all about pride. It's all about pride. And now let's talk about how the water, remember now we spoke about the firmament, there's the firmament up here, and then there's the waters when it rains, because there's no precipitation according to this scientist lies. Now, when it rains, it's because Sonini decides that he wants water to come down on earth, that's it. No scientific things. So this here, let me show you now how this water changes form. Like I promised earlier on that I'm going to share with you how. So this water that's in the top of firmament, the breath of Sonini, ice is given. So when he decides he wants snow to rain down, he breathes on that water. And that water turns to ice. As soon as it rains down as ice. I mean, that's magnificent. Even think about it. That ice, that snow, the snow is not the same, it's not the same form as ice. It's a different form called snow. Right, so it's not something that them scientists can put together. So then he knew that them scientists are going to be tripping you. So he didn't put. So if you put ice and put snow, the molecular structure is totally different. So for snow, each structure is different from the next drop of snow. I mean, that's really magnificent. Not one molecular structure of a snow is similar to the next. That's very magnificent. Ice, every molecular structure of ice is the same. Hydrogen, oxygen, the fuse, that's it. Snow, totally different. Each and every one of them is different. That shows how Sonini is meticulous in whatever he's doing. I'm not trying to advertise him through this now. I mean, he don't need my advertisement. But I'm just telling the truth that he is very meticulous. You can just tell from looking at the evidence, things that he's doing. So that's why, I mean, the devil is even jealous. But the devil is a loser. Because how you win against somebody who can do stuff like that? Who created you? I mean, really. So look at this. I mean, and then it goes on to say, and the breath of the waters is frozen. Now, at the breath of the waters, water is frozen. So he breathes, and then the water is frozen. That's it. And then he breathes, and the frost comes down. It's only about his breath. Only about this breath. That's it. So you do understand, you know. So now let's talk about, you know, I want to expose this thing. Because the earth is not round. And all of these lies now, these scientists have been feeding us. They have to catch up with them lies. You know how hard it is to be consistent with a lie? And a whole lot of things is not consistent anymore now. First of all, the spinning doesn't work with the Bible. the spinning coming from the scientists, don't work with the Bible. The rain, precipitation, it doesn't hold waters because how does then the water turns to snow if it precipitated, according to them, scientists, and then they form dark clouds because of the water evaporated, you know, condensation thing we learned at school. And then when it comes, and then comes down, that's what scientists say. Then who decides it's going to be snow now? Who decides to get the dew every morning? You know, when you wake up in the morning, you see the grass will be wet every morning. Now, how does the precipitation principle then work in there? The condensation theory from the, how does, you see the scientists think, these people are not as smart as they think, you know, I'm telling you now. And I mean, they feed us lies. I read in the other article that they, all these discoverers, who's this one, this rocket scientist, I read somewhere that they were lying, even he didn't do nothing. But we, you know, he's famous of some, he discovered this and that. I mean, really. But anyway, so, you know, think about it. So, this really, even, I'm showing you different things that are exposing it. That the earth is not round at all. Why they're lying? Because they don't want to expose that darkness place that they were confined in. They're still confined, waiting for that judgment. When Sonini come back, he'd say, okay, oh, they're all in the darkness. Go, just go straight and go burn now. And then all of them others that are on top of the earth that have been supporting those kingdom of darkness, go burn with them. That's it. I mean, this is so simple and understandable. But they don't want to acknowledge that they've been confined there because pride. You can see that pride among some people here on earth already. They got pride. The minute somebody got pride, you know, ooh, he's tapping into that kingdom of darkness now. That pride. That, no, I'm not. It's me. You can't have that. So think about it. So here's another part that I wanted, you know, to show y'all. You know, talking about this moon eclipse, sun and moon eclipse, and, you know, they've been talking about we're going to have, okay, just watch this little video, and you tell me now. Knowing the sun and the moon is only moving one to the other, and the moon is moving probably slower because it has to change form to show us. You know, look at that. Okay, that's the moon eclipse now. They say this is how it's going to happen. Okay, today now, we're waiting for it today. They say the moon, the fact that the sun is going dark is because the moon came and obscured and stood in front of it. And then the sun can't shine, it's cramped. get off moon, on my way. That's what happens. I mean, what a blue lie. That's a very blue lie. How do they even think that we're going to be? Look at the Bible. Let's look at the Bible. What the Bible says about the sun getting dark. Nothing about a moon coming to stand in front of anything. So then it decides, sun, from now on, for the next whatever hours, you're going to turn dark. You're not going to shine. And the sun says, yeah, sure. And then it don't shine. That's it. Everything obeys on it on earth everywhere. On top of in heaven, on top of the earth, and under the earth. Everything obeys on it. That's it. And the pride of the demons of the devil and everybody following them, king of darkness, that pride, that's why they don't want that to be acknowledged. Because they want us to think they're still in control. I mean, think about it. But they're not in control because they can't even support their arguments. Okay, look at the Bible verses about how things turn dark. And you tell me, is there anything that blocks anything? Look at Acts 2:20. The sun will be turned into darkness. Not closed, or turned into darkness, and the moon into blood or blood. And then Revelation 6:12. I looked. He broke into six seals, and the sun became black. All these things just turned black. Suddenly tells them, you must turn black. Not moon, go in front of the sun. No, turn black. And then Ezekiel 32:8, I mean, there's a whole lot of verses in the Bible supporting this. I'm going to pull all of them, in fact, all of them. So you can see it's so abundant in the Bible. Ezekiel 32:8, there's probably 10 of them. I pull them. 32:8. The heavens, I will darken. Now, that's even showing Sonini himself talking about, I will darken over you. All the shining lights in the heavens, I will darken. Now, you tell me, is the moon having the power to just go and stand? If it's a coincidence? No, he just tells it to turn dark. That's Ezekiel 32:8. Let's look at another one. Joel, I mean, there's many of them. Joel 2:10, grow dark. The sun and the moon grow dark. I bolded the main parts that I want to focus on. I don't be reading the other part. Just focus on the darkening part so that you understand that things become dark because somebody told them to get dark, not somebody because of the moon coming to stand. So if the sun becomes dark today, as they said, there's going to be a sun eclipse today. We're waiting, got all them glasses to watch this thing when it happens. So if that happens, it will be because Sonini told the sun not to shine, not because the moon is standing in front of it. And I've never, not even on YouTube, everywhere, I've never seen somebody's cell phone recording the moon going then and then there's a moon coming. Not even in the media, showing the moon going right in front of the sun. All we see is the sun getting dark. That's all we see. We don't see the moon going in front of the sun. Why? Because that won't happen, don't work like that. Look at this one. Ecclesiastes, Amos saying that they make the sun go down. I will make the sun go down at noon. That shows Sonini is the instruction. It tell this sun and moon what to do. Get dark now, don't go down now, don't reverse. You remember what happened in, is it Nehemiah? Nehemiah, where Sonini told the sun to reverse, go back three times, go backwards. Instead of going forward, east to west, go backwards now, west to east. I mean, just think about it. Because I need to tell these things. What Ecclesiastes 12:2 stars are darkened. Ezekiel 32:7 will not give its light. You understand now? Ain't no something standing in front of anything. I mean, Joel 3, there's a whole lot of them. You could read, you could be tired. Joel 3:15, grow dark. Matthew 24:9, be darkened. Matthew 13:24, not give its light. 3, Joel 2:1, turn into darkness. Isaiah 13:9, flash forth their light. Not flash forth their light. That means not shine. Will not shed its light. Will not, I mean, will not shine, will not dark, will not, will turn dark. Will not. There's nothing talking about the moon tempering with this shining sun. Because everything is in order. Suddenly everything is order. Nothing clashes with anything else. Nobody fights up in heaven. Nobody be talking about, you know, the star is standing in my way. Get over, you know. There's nothing. Suddenly things is order, order, order. It's only the king of darkness where the demons be fighting. You see them in prison. They be fighting each other over there. And then you see the king of darkness, so much no order in there. And now they're trying to implicate that into the Sonini's kingdom. It cannot work like that. And then with the new, I'll show you now, with the new updated versions of the Bible. Now they're talking about, in Luke, they updated now the Bible. So they say, because the sun was obscured and the veil of the temple was torn into two. Now if you remember this situation, that's when the Savior died on the cross, right? So the sun became dark. The whole Bible been saying the sun became dark. Now all of a sudden these new versions, now they've been trying to update the Bible. They say no, the sun was obscured. By what? Because there was no sun eclipse on that day. Now they tell it was obscured. They can't even say by what, because they can't say no, there was sun. They will pull up the history and say, okay, there was there sun eclipse on that day. No, then what was obscuring it then? Now they just say it was obscured. They don't want to incriminate themselves. They say, because the sun was obscured. They just, you know, throwing things in there. And they're throwing things in a wrong situation because everybody knows the sun turned dark. The seventh hour, the sun turned dark. Ninth hour, he cried, Eli Lama Sabachthani. But the sun turned dark. Is it sixth hour or one of them hours? The sun turned dark. That's what the Bible been saying. The whole, the Mandela effect don't work here. We remember what happened. We can tell you now. No Mandela effect here. The sun turned dark. This was obscured. Is the latest version. We're talking about, you know, people are illusionary. That's how it was. It was obscured. It's just an addition because they want to factor in or give room to them lies. So it was obscured. Then there was an eclipse, something obscured. No, then obscuration, nothing. Okay? So, now look at Isaiah. Isaiah is just even exposing how this devil and these demons and them scientists who are supporting the kingdom of darkness, they're so powerless. They don't have the power people give them. I mean, we gotta do is just open the scripture, and that's it. And then whatever they've been preaching out there is just off, because we just read in the Bible, and if it clashes, then that's it. There's nothing. So look at this. Isaiah even claimed, "They that see thee," now thee is devil, "shall narrowly look upon thee, devil, and consider thee, saying, is this the man that made the earth tremble, that did shake the kingdoms with all them lies and everything?" I mean, this time will come where everybody going to be looking narrowly. Some people will going to be, oh, look scornfully. Some version says we're looking at him, you know, strangely, with scorn, looking at the devil. He'll be sitting in some corner, timid as hell, because he ain't got nothing else to do. He'll be sitting in some corner, and then, you know, people will be looking at him. Is this really him that deceived everybody? Unbelievable how powerless he will look in that time. But then, don't want to believe none of these lies. I'm encouraging you to this video to read for yourself so you don't believe. I mean, if they have confidence to teach us this poison right here about the earth being round, and even when everything else is clashing, they still have confidence to go on and teach us about this thing. Why are they getting that? Where are they getting this confidence from? From us not reading on our own and depending on them feeding us through them churches, through them. We don't want to depend on them. We can go to church and listen to the sermon, but don't just depend on that. Come back and study for self and uncover stuff, because them preachers won't tell you everything. Don't talk about things that are against who's funding them, because them churches, they're funded by the government, and the government is pushed by the devil, because the devil got the money, and the government to stand needs the money. The devil said, I'll give you millions of dollars if you do this and this for me, you government. And the government got to do it. So you have to take into account that this is a network. You cannot conform to that and still think you're going to have the truth. You have to be out of the box. Think out of the box and go on your own and study for yourself and uncover the truth. Bye.